He has a voice, certainly, and an ability that has put him in front of the camera for great things. Lost, Lord of the Rings, Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker, now lending his voice to another type of story. Star of Blood Ties, it's Dominic Monaghan. Dominic, nice to see you. Good morning to you.
Ah, you joined me here in my laboratory. Let me take off my very expensive. How's it going?
Very, very well. You know what? They're saying this is a podcast, but between you and me, and this is a radio drama. That's what it is.
It is. It's like an old-fashioned kind of radio drama that plays out episodically. If you've not heard the first season, you can go back and listen to it. It's kind of the story of a family who are dealing with a tragedy and trying to work out what to do next with the huge amount of finances and responsibility that they find themselves with.
So what I think is so interesting here is we know Dirty John, of course, based in Southern California. There are a lot of examples of what I'll describe as true crime stories that became hugely popular podcasts. And now, which is the obvious way to go, the folks at Wondery have commissioned a fictional series of radio dramas that I imagine play like these true crime dramas played.
Yeah, exactly. A little whodunit, a little cloak and dagger. Week by week, they leave you with some cliffhangers. I've been lucky enough over the years to be involved with shows that have a lot of cliffhangers associated with them. It's a great way to get people to come back. Also, in these times, as we know, Sam, people are much more inclined to binge things because they have that time on their hands. If you like the first episode, you can watch all of the first season. You can watch the show unfold in front of your ears instead of your eyes and paint the picture in your own mind.
I was a fan growing up. The KNX here locally in L.A. used to play the CBS Radio Mystery Theater every night at 9 o'clock, and I was absolutely glued. And I think the mind's eye sometimes is much more effective than your actual eyes. You've got big stars in this alongside with you. Tell me why this is so appealing to you.
Well, look, I mean, in these times, it's important for me to work. You know, I've obviously been isolating and being as safe as possible, trying to be part of the solution instead of the problem. And in Los Angeles, we have some very interesting new numbers coming in. At times, it's just important for me to not be gardening, not be with my animals, not be in a recreational headspace, flex that muscle. I've been friends with Josh Gad for a while. He's a lovely man. He's been doing some great things to raise people's spirits in these times. We did a massive Lord of the Rings reunion that Josh Gad was involved in. And his company and he were doing this thing. They brought me in to play the kind of English dastardly man trying to take over their family. You know how American dramas, they tend to pull in an English sounding person, you know, because they're the original bad guy. And it's just fun for me to flex my muscles as an actor, you know.
Well, I tell you what, it's very effective. Here's a clip from this. Take a listen to this.
Oh, if it isn't David Hammer, my favorite CEO.
Eleanor. Hey, great news. We're golden. Deal is done.
It is?
Yeah, I just got the okay from your lawyer. We can sign tomorrow after the board meeting.
But I'm not going to be at the board meeting because I have exams to grade and grant proposals to write.
Okay, great. Then work on the flight.
What?
I'm sending the company jet for you.
David, I got to be honest. I kind of don't want to do that at all.
But I think it would be a nice gesture for you to show up in person, to show that this is a friendly breakup, you know, a conscious uncoupling between Richland Health and his favorite daughter.
Sounds good, and I can hear your evil, Dominic. I can really hear it.
Yeah, you know, it's fun. I don't tend to play, you know, really bad guys too often. This is someone who, he's a CEO of a previous company. He tries to become CEO of this company. He's basically trying to, you know, take control of the company, take the money, and the family are trying to wield their own power. It's fun. It reminded me a little bit of Succession on HBO. So if you're a fan of that show, worth listening to this one.
Well, we'll tell folks how they can. We'll let you get back to the laboratory. Blood Ties Season 2, Episode 1 and 2, they're out now. New episodes every Wednesday. This is available on Wondery Plus, Apple, Spotify, Google, wherever podcasts are played. Quick break here. Morning news for Thursday. We're back in just a minute.